Blessed people, the Lord spoke with me this past night. This past night, the Lord did show me his two mightiest prophets ministering in a meeting. They were ministering in a meeting somewhere, and then God, the Holy Spirit, descended down from heaven in bodily form, in the form of a very super glorious white dove that came all the way flapping, flapping. It came vertically down, flapping, 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 until it came and settled on the crown of the head of who is speaking with you now. Now, this past night, I have seen God the Holy Spirit descend from heaven in bodily form as a dove, a white, super glorious, huge dove that came and settled on my head. So this past night, God himself, the Godhead, settled on my head in this conversation that the Lord is having with the church. This unrelenting, very constant and continuous conversation that the Lord is having with the church regarding the glorious coming of the Messiah. And hence, you can see that in that conversation of this night, he's talking about the latter anointing, the latter visitation, and the latter glory of the Lord. Again, this past night, God the Holy Spirit, he descended from heaven in bodily form, and the Lord placed me, he lifted me up above the earth so I could see him coming to these two prophets. And then he descended vertically, flapping, flapping his wings as he came down, super glorious. Everything became very glorious as he descended. And then when he descended, I found that he settled on my head. I was again down there where he settled on my head. He settled on the head of the two prophets of the Lord. Then after that, settled on them. And then he began gliding only the way he normally does, gliding, going up. Very swift though, but gliding, slide back, very swift, going up again. Then he went up and entered the heaven. So this is the kind of conversation that the Lord is engaging the church in. I have seen a meeting where God the Holy Spirit descends upon his two tremendous prophets. He comes to me. He settles on my head and he lights on the head the way he did the Messiah by the Jordan River. So this is the level of conversation that heaven has now reached with the Church of Christ. If this were to summon the attention of the hearts and the souls of men to the fact that, number one, the latter glory that was biblically promised in Haggai chapter 2, verses 6 to 9, that is promised in the book of John chapter 2, when the Lord turned water into wine, the latter wine, the second wine, Joel chapter 2, 22-23, if this was meant to underscore the latter promised anointing in the Bible, then surely he is doing everything to reach the hearts and the souls of men that they may enter into the glorious eternal kingdom of God. This was supposed to be a bell ringing out, a trumpeting for everyone now to return to holiness, receive Christ Jesus as Lord and Savior, and return to holiness. Then what am I going to summon the attention of the souls and the hearts of men? And number two, if this was to mention to you very clearly, without a doubt, and make a clarion call that the Messiah is coming, then surely he has achieved it. This past night, God the Holy Spirit himself, in bodily form, sent by God the Father, he came all the way flapping, flapping, glorious, everything super glorious around him. And as he came down, and then he lighted my head. The Lord lifted me up here. I saw him descending, and then when he recognized myself, he lighted my head, and he accomplished his mission. That means we need to prepare the way, blessed people, the Messiah, the King, Christ Jesus of Nazareth, my Lord and my Redeemer, he is coming. The Messiah is coming, and I've seen the Holy Spirit, God, the Holy Spirit, the Godhead, this past night, sent on me. These are historic moments. Remember, only the Messiah, ever since eternity, into eternity, has never lighted on anyone else. Only the Messiah was inaugurated in that form and introduced to the universe and to heaven in that form when he entered the office of the Christ. The military duty of the Christ, of the Messiah, to come and fight sin and Satan. Now you see, he has identified these two messengers, these two prophets of the book of Revelation, chapter 11, in same manner. We remember January 1, 2009, at Buwehu Stadium, Kakamega, when he did that. Now he has done that again. The Messiah is coming. It was our shalom and his trust.